Hey guys, welcome back to my channel. So in today's video, I wanted to show you guys how you can achieve an extremely flawless foundation application. One of the biggest nightmares of a beginner in makeup is to have cakey foundation, especially like, you know, on a special occasion. You take so much effort, you know, buying the right foundation, buying the right concealer, buying the right powder, and then you apply everything and you go out and people are like, oh my god, you're wearing too much makeup, your makeup looks really cakey. And it's just so heartbreaking, especially for someone who loves makeup, to make sure that, you know, all these products that you spend money and time buying, you need to get the maximum out of these products. I hope this video helps you in gaining some tips on how you can avoid cakey foundation. So if you want to know how you can achieve this flawless base makeup application, just keep watching. Your foundation gets cakey not just because of the foundation that you use, but also because of the nature of your skin itself. So if you have really dry, flaky skin, your foundation is not going to sit well on your face. So you need to prep your face in order to allow the foundation to lay really flawlessly on top. So there are two ways in which you can do this. One is exfoliation, and the other one is face shaving. So to start off, make sure that your skin is very well exfoliated, because the number one reason for cakey foundation is dry, flaky skin. So always make sure that you exfoliate your skin at least twice a week. If you have sensitive skin, try doing it like once a week and, like, you know, push forward and make it twice a week. There are two types of exfoliants that you can use. One is the physical exfoliant and the other is a chemical exfoliant. Now in recent times, physical exfoliation has been debunked, as in people are saying that using a physical exfoliant can be very damaging to your skin in the long run. But personally, I feel like a physical exfoliant works well for me, especially a walnut scrub. I know it's extremely controversial right now because everybody talks about not using a physical abrasive on your face, but I use the St. Ives walnut scrub maybe once a week, and I make sure that I don't rub it into my skin too much. I just gently massage it onto my face and then I'll wash it. I'll use it like a face wash. So that's a physical exfoliant where you have physical particles that slough away all the dead skin. The next type of exfoliant is a chemical exfoliant, which is basically acids, AHA and BHA acids. So there's this peeling solution by The Ordinary which I use. This one I'll use like once a week. So I'll use the St. Ives one once a week and I'll use this one once a week. So I'll exfoliate my face twice a week. You can use either one of these two to exfoliate your skin, whatever works well for you. These two are the products that work really well for me, especially because I have dry skin. Another reason why your foundation can look cakey is because of all the peach fuzz on your face. So I would advise you to shave your face. I mean, if you have really coarse hair on your face, I wouldn't advise you to shave, because when the hair grows back, it can be like really thick and blunt. But if you have like really fine peach fuzz, you can just use a face razor. You can just use a face razor like this one. You get these on Amazon. It's a disposable face razor. It's just a couple hundred rupees for three razors. So I use this to shave all the peach fuzz off of my face. Along with the peach fuzz, it also removes any dead skin on the surface of your face, especially on your nose. So I do this probably every 3-4 days. Now, one thing you need to remember is when you're shaving your face, make sure that you give your face a break that day. You don't apply any sort of makeup or any sort of chemicals that can irritate your skin, because your face can be extremely sensitive right after you've shaved. So I do this particularly on days where I know that I'm not gonna wear any makeup or I'm not gonna go out. These two are the main tips I can give you to keep your skin extremely soft and supple, which in turn helps your foundation from not getting cakey. So my face is well exfoliated and shaved at the moment. Now I'm just gonna move forward into prepping my face. And for this, I'm gonna use a really good moisturizer. I've already cleansed and toned my face. I'm going to be using Neutrogena's Hydro Boost Face Gel as a moisturizer. This has hyaluronic acid, so it helps in plumping up your skin really well. And in turn, that helps your foundation apply much smoother. So I'll just pick it up on my finger. Just apply it and I'll gently massage it in. Now if you feel like your face is excessively dry, you can use a face oil. I feel like my face is pretty okay, especially because it's summer. I tend to use face oils only during the night. So during daytime, I'll use a regular face moisturizer like this one. Now, if you're going out, please, please don't forget to use sunscreen because it's very, very important. The kind of damage that the sun can do to your face over a period of time, it's like really horrifying. So always make sure that you apply a good sunscreen. Now, since I'm dark skinned, most of the sunscreens that you find in the market don't really suit me. It leaves that white cast, whereas this one, this is Neutrogena's Ultra Sheer Sunblock. It's got SPF 50 in it. This does not leave a white cast on my face and it's also really moisturizing, so it suits my dry skin really well. So I'll just generously apply it all over my forehead, cheeks, and don't forget the neck. You need to make sure that you massage it into your face so that, you know, it absorbs into your skin really well. Our main aim is to make the face really supple and soft. So if you feel like it's a little dry, just spritz your face with a little bit of MAC Prep and Prime face mist so that it brings back that hydration. Also, don't forget to apply lip balm. So now my skin is really well prepped. I can feel like it's extremely soft and ready to grab onto that foundation. So the foundation I'm going to be using is the regular that I use on my channel. It's the LA Girl Pro Coverage Foundation. This foundation is amazing for dry skin. It has the right amount of dewiness. I can tell you right off the bat, if you have oily skin, you're going to hate this. You're going to be a grease ball at the end of the day. It just looks really good on my dry skin. So what I'm gonna do is, I'm going to apply the foundation with a brush. I used to apply my foundation with a sponge directly, but since this is really liquidy, if I use a sponge to directly apply, it's gonna soak up all my product. So what I'm gonna do is, I'm just gonna take this on a foundation brush like this, like a flat kabuki brush like this. I'll take just one full pump. Now the key to making your foundation not look cakey is to apply the bare minimum. Try to get as much as coverage you can with the minimum amount of product. So I'm just taking one pump onto my foundation brush. So I'll start off with the center point of my face, which is around my nose, around my mouth, basically the center zone. So I'm just gonna apply this and blend it out. So always remember, start off with very little amount. You don't want to pile on the foundation because whenever you pile on product, that is when it tends to collect in all the crevices of your face and it makes it look cakey. So what you need to do is start off from the center of your face with the bare minimum product. Now I've just roughly applied the foundation onto my face. Next, what I'm gonna do is I'm gonna pick up a damp sponge. You need to make sure that your sponge is damp, which means you need to get it really wet, wring all the water out, and probably squeeze it into a paper towel so that, you know, there's no excess water, but the sponge is damp. Because if your sponge is wet, it's just gonna mess up your foundation. So make sure that your sponge is really damp. And just gently buff your foundation out. So when you do this, you are pushing the foundation into your skin and it really meshes well with your skin and makes it look like second skin. You don't want the foundation to sit on top of your skin, which the brush does. When you apply with a brush, it tends to just leave the foundation on top. So you need to push it into your skin. Also, the areas where you get cakey, which is around the nose and around the mouth, make sure that you push the foundation into those areas really well. If you feel like your face is a bit dry, just re-dampen your sponge with Fix Plus and go all over your face. Now this just helps the foundation to melt into your skin. So make sure it's really well blended out. You don't want your foundation to collect in any areas. So just run your sponge all over your face and make sure that the outer perimeters of your face are really blended out. You don't want like a demarcation on your face, you know, from the foundation. So blend it out really well, especially around your brows. You know, these are the areas where your foundation can get cakey, around your brows, around your nose, around your mouth. So give a little bit of extra TLC to those areas and you're good to go. So I've spent around 5 minutes blending my face. The more you practice, the faster you can blend out your foundation. But my advice would be to spend good time, you know, allowing that foundation to settle into your skin. Now that the foundation is done, we can move on to concealer. To add a bit of dimension to my face, I'm going to be using the LA Girl Pro Conceal Concealer in the shade Creamy Beige. Now, this is a couple of shades lighter than my skin tone, but I like the dimension that it gives to my face when I apply this. So I don't apply too much. Again, minimal product. The more you pile on your makeup, the cakier it's gonna get. So make sure that you apply only what is necessary. I personally don't like it when people pile on too much of concealer. It's a huge pet peeve of mine. So I have applied this concealer to all the highlight zones of my face, which are under my eyes, the bridge of my nose, my forehead, under my cheekbones and chin. Now what you're going to do is you're going to take the same sponge, probably wet it again with the Fix Plus. Now the Fix Plus contains glycerin, so when you wet your sponge with Fix Plus and blend out your concealer, that glycerin is going to blend in well with the concealer and lock it into place. So I start off with the inner corners of my under eyes and I'll work my way out. You want to work your way out towards your temples. You know, drag that concealer all the way to your temples. Like you want like a nice wash of lightness right under your eyes, all the way to your temples. What it does is it will give you that lifted effect. Like your face is gonna look snatched, like you just got a facelift. Do the same to the left eye as well. Bridge of my nose, forehead, Cupid's bow, chin, along those smile lines. Never drag your beauty blender over your foundation because it's just gonna move the product all around. What you need to do is you need to blend in a tapping motion. In order to avoid cakey foundation, your best friend is a damp beauty sponge. So just let the sponge do the work. Again, go around the nose a couple of times. You don't want the foundation to crease over there. Run the sponge all over your face one last time. Now that the cream products are on, we can move on to setting the face. So I'm going to use a translucent powder. Now this is the RCMA No Color Powder. I've just put it into a Clinique tub. It works really well for my dry skin. Other powders usually tend to dry my skin out, but this one is like perfect for me. If you have really oily skin, I would suggest you to use Laura Mercier's translucent powder. So before the cream products can settle down into fine lines, I'm going to set my face. So I'm just gonna pick it up on the same sponge, like so. And I'm going to set my under eyes first because that's where it creases first. So I'll just press the powder into my skin. I'll also push it into the corners of my nose because my foundation can crease there as well. I also crease around my mouth, so I'll apply a little bit of powder in the corners of my mouth. And also on your cheekbone, whatever excess powder is there. I don't want to apply too much powder. So whatever excess powder is on my sponge, I'm just gonna tap it all over my cheekbone area. Because when you apply your bronzer, you want it to be a matte surface. You don't want there to be any tackiness, because if this area is tacky and if you apply the bronzer, the powder bronzer on top of that, it's just gonna be patchy. So you need to make sure that the foundation over there is extremely set. Same for the contours of my forehead. You don't want there to be any tackiness. So I'll just apply a little bit of powder there. Now, if you have oily skin, you can leave the powder on for some time, like till you do your eye makeup or something like that, you know, so that the powder bakes the cream product underneath and makes it bulletproof. But I have dry skin, so I'm not gonna leave the powder on for too long. I'll just take a fluffy brush like this and I'll kick off all the excess powder. Okay, now that our face is really well powdered, what I'm gonna do is I'm gonna bronze up my skin. So for that, I'm gonna be using MAC Mineralized Skin Finish in the shade Dark. Now this is just a shade darker than my skin tone. It's not gonna give you like a stark bronzy effect, but it's much more natural. What I like to do is I like to give an overall bronze with this product, and then I would like to contour my face using a darker product. So I'll pick this up on a fluffy brush like this. This is a Real Techniques brush, but it works really well as a bronzer brush. So I'll just gently sweep it across the contours of my face just to bring back some color and dimension. So what I'll do is I'll apply it in a 3. See, right from the contours of your forehead all the way to your cheekbones and under your jawline. Now that the overall bronzing is done, I want to add more dimension to my contour or bronze using a darker product. So for that, I'm going to be using MAC Studio Fix powder in the shade NW45. So I'm just going to pick it up on a smaller fluffy brush like this, and I'm going to apply it to my contour. And while I'm applying, I'm just going to buff it out in circular motions. Now I don't want to dig the brush too roughly onto my face. I'll just gently buff it out. Make sure that you push the bronzer into your hairline. You don't want there to be any demarcation there again. Tap the double chin. Okay, now that my bronzer is well blended out, I'm going to lock all these powders into place using the MAC Fix Plus again. So I'm just gently gonna mist my face. Now, in order to avoid a cakey look, you need to minimize the powderiness of your face makeup. So that's the reason why with every layer of powder, I'm gonna be misting my face with a face mist like this. It'll just allow all the powders to mesh and blend well into each other without looking like it's sitting on top of your face. That is when it looks cakey. So now that the mist has dried on my face, I'm going to apply blush. So for blush, I have an all-time favorite blush palette. Actually, two palettes. One is the Golden Sugar Rose Gold 2 palette. This is by Makeup Revolution. I really love their face powders. They are like really good. All their ultra blush palettes are like really nice and very affordable. It's just if you buy them on sale, I'm sure you can get them like for 800 or 900 rupees. They have a nice array of blushes in this palette. This is the Ultra Blush palette in the variant Sugar and Spice. This is like a nice peachy coral blush, and this is significantly more pink. So I'll take a combination of these two. So what I'm gonna do is I'm gonna pick up a brush like this, a blush brush, and I'm gonna pick up these two blushes, tap off the excess, and just apply it onto the apples of my cheeks. Always remember the two-finger rule. You don't want your blush to come beyond this zone. If you bring it too far into your face, it's gonna look like your features are extremely closed together, which is not very ideal. You want your face to look lifted. So what you're gonna do is you're gonna apply the blush right from here. Now you place two fingers here, so you start applying the blush right from here. So just gently graze the brush on top of your face. Don't press too much, don't apply too much pressure. Just gently apply the blush, like you're powdering a baby's little bum or something like that. Do the same to the left cheek as well. Now the thing with blush is it fades really fast. So even if you feel like you've gone a little overboard, it's okay. Within an hour or two, it's gonna like fade. So don't worry about that. Initially, even if you look like you have clown cheeks, blend it really well with your contour. Bring a little to the tip of your nose and your chin. and your forehead as well, so that you know it looks really cohesive and like you're blushing naturally. Now the next product that I'm gonna use is a fine highlighter. I've talked about this in my minimal everyday glam makeup tutorial, which you can check out. I'll leave a link right here or right there, I'm not sure, one of these two sides. So I use a really finely milled highlighter powder, which is this one, this powder right here in the Ultra Blush palette, Golden Sugar 2. So I'll pick that up on the same blush brush and I'll use it as a blush topper. Now what this does is it just gives that really subtle glow, like an overall glow, which is so beautiful and it looks almost angelic. I don't think it'll be very evident on camera, but in person it makes a huge difference. So I like to bring it a little forward onto the apples of my cheeks, so that, you know, since I have really chubby cheeks, when I smile, it's just gonna catch the light and it's so beautiful. So I'm just gonna bring it a little onto the apples of my cheeks and I'm gonna pull it back. This highlight has a little bit of a pink undertone in it, so it blends with your blush really well, which I really like. Now that you've applied the blush and the fine highlight, you can again go ahead and mist your face, so that everything meshes into one. Another thing I like to do is I like to pick up my damp sponge and take the bum of the sponge and I'll mist the bottom part of the sponge and I'll just gently, like, you know, dab it onto my cheeks so that, you know, it really meshes all these powders together, like, really well. Bring it onto your chin, the tip of your nose, your forehead. It's just gonna mesh everything together. Okay, now that the face mist has dried, I want to pay a little bit of attention to my under eyes. My under eyes have become a little dull because of all the powders we've applied on the cheeks. So what I'm gonna do is I'm gonna use a highlight powder. This is just a regular face powder. This is a MAC Studio Fix powder in the shade NC42, which is 2-3 shades lighter than my natural skin match, which is NC44.5. So I'm just gonna pick it up on a fluffy brush like this. And I'm just gonna apply it onto my under eyes, you know, so that a little bit of the light is brought back. And I'm gonna drag it to my temples, apply it onto the sides of my nose. Now what this does is it will create a nice contrast between your cheek area and your under eyes, which in turn brings a lot of attention to the center of your face. So if you feel like you've brought the contour or your blush too far into your face, you can also apply this powder around your nose, you know, to round it out. I also like to apply it right under my contour, you know, to just sharpen it up a bit and gently blend it out. Now if you feel like it's too harsh, just take your blush brush or your bronzer brush and blend it out a little more so it's more cohesive. Okay, now that's done, I want to apply a little bit more highlight. I want something a little more stark. So I'll just pick up this highlighter over here. Or what I'll do is I'll just take the same blush brush. I want to apply it, like, swoop it over my cheeks. So I'll just pick it up on the same brush, tap off the excess and just run it on top of my cheekbones, right onto the tip of my nose, chin, and in between my eyes. Now that that's applied, I'm again gonna mist my face with the MAC Fix Plus. Like I said, it's key to allow these powders to all mesh into one another. So till the face mist dries, just keep your face relaxed and, you know, allow it to dry. Now in the meantime, what I'm gonna do is I'm gonna do my brows. So this is my regular brow routine. I just don't want to bore you guys with the same products and the same techniques. So it's just an eyeshadow by MAC. It's called Brune. I'll just pick it up on an angled brush like this and I'll just fill out my brows. So I just applied a lipstick onto my mouth, which is, I think this is the ColourPop lipstick in the shade Thursday. This came in one of their lip bundles like I guess a year ago. I don't think they make this anymore, but I'm sure you can find similar colors on their website. This is just a cool toned berry pink, which I love. It suits my skin tone really well. So I hope you found this video extremely helpful on your makeup journey. If you're someone who wanted to start getting into makeup, but then you feel extremely overwhelmed with the amount of products you find on the market and you don't know what to do, just take it step by step. You know, practice. Start off with powder foundation, and once you have nailed that, you can move on to liquid foundations, and once you've nailed that, you can move on to cream foundations, and so and so. So it's important to not allow yourself to get overwhelmed. Just take it step by step. I hope this video was helpful. And if you're able to avoid a cakey foundation application because of the tips on this video, please send me pictures and tag me in your pictures on Instagram so that I know. I'll leave the links to my social media down in the description box below. I hope you guys enjoyed watching this video. Please stay tuned for more videos. So until then, always remember, fair isn't the only lovely. Bye.